Assalamualaikum and very good morning to my dear students. Welcome to my Arabic class. How are you all? La'allakum bikhairin. Right? Arabic पढ़ते हो तो sentence का meaning भी आता ही होगा. I hope you all are well. Okay? Alhamdulillah for that. So my dear students, in last video of Arabic we discuss about exercise number 1 of lesson number 5. Exercise number 1 of lesson number 5. So today we are going to discuss exercise number 2. As you can see on your screen, and which one is that? Tarjim ilal injliziyati. Live class mein maine aapko ye padha diya hai. I taught you this exercise in live class. But then also we send you a video that some of the students who miss our live class with any genuine reason, so they can watch this video and understood properly. And then after also someone have any kind of doubt regarding to lesson or exercise or grammar, they can ask me in my live class. Okay, I'll explain you beta. So now we will discuss about second exercise, Tarjim ilal Injliziyati, means translate into English, right? You can see on your screen, this is our 5th standard Arabic book page, page number 39. See the first sentence, what is that? Haza rajulun tawilun. Haza means this, rajulun means man, tawilun means tall. This is a tall man. This man is tall, this is also a correct answer. When you do a wordly translation, that time some of the word is going here and there in English, because Arabic and English is both opposite size language, right? So that's why. But if you do a wordly translation and it is correct, then I'll give you a correct. Okay? So haza rajulun tawilun, this is a tall man. Number 2, zalika hajarun thaqilun. Zalika means that. Hajarun means stone, thakilun means heavy. Why they are using here zalika? Because hajarun is a masculine word. That's why they are using zalika. Before this first sentence they use haza, and you can see in third sentence they are using hazihi. So why they are using hazihi here? Because zahratun word is a feminine. So this is the what we call asmaul ishara in Arabic. In English, we called it demonstrative pronouns, okay? So, whenever we have to show the thing, person or animal nearby us, that time we use haza for a male, hazihi for a female. And whenever we have to show the thing, person or animal far by us, that time we use zalika for a male and tilka for a female, right? हम इसको अरबिक में अस्माउल इशारा कहते हैं और इंग्लिश में हम इसे डेमोस्टेटिव प्रोनाउंस कहते हैं. नियर बाय को हम कहते हैं अस्माउल इशारा लिल करीब, और यू कैन से इसमें इशारा लिल करीब, एंड फार बाय इसमें इशारा लिल बाईद. सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर यूजिंग सम ऑफ द प्लेस हाजा, सम प्लेस जालिका, एंड सम प्लेस हाजीही और तिलका. But you have to know properly when they are we use haza, when we use hazihi, when we use, where we use zalika and tilka. So second sentence is zalika hajarun thakilun, that is a heavy stone. Number 3, hazihi zahratun jamilatun, this is a beautiful flower. This is a beautiful flower. Now turn the page, page number 40. So number 4 is tilka bakaratun sagiratun, that is a small cow. Tilka means that, bakaratun means cow, sagiratun means small. You can see here they are using sagiratun after bakaratun. Why? Because bakaratun word is a feminine, so that's why they are using tilka, not zalika. Okay, beta? So tilka bakaratun sagiratun, that is a small cow. Number 5, haza darsun sahlun, this is a easy lesson. This is a easy lesson. Your lesson is also a very easy. So haza for this, darsun means a lesson, and its plural is durusun. Sahlun means easy. हाजा दर्सुन सहलुन दिस इज अ इजी लेसन. नंबर सिक्स जालिक कलमुहु दैट इज हीज पेन. जालिक मीन्स दैट, कलमुन मीन्स पेन, हु मीन्स हीज, दैट इज हीज पेन. यू कैन सी हियर दे आर अटैच हियर हु. वॉट इज दैट, वॉट वी कॉल्ड इट इन अरबिक, जमाइर. वॉट वी कॉल्ड इट प्रोनाउंस जमाइर. एंड हाउ मैनी टाइप ऑफ जमाइर, टू टाइप ऑफ जमाइर, जमीर मुत्तसिला एंड जमीर मुनफसिला. जमीर मुत्तसिला मीन्स अटैच प्रोनाउंस एंड जमीर मुनफसिला मीन्स डिटैच प्रोनाउंस. अटैच प्रोनाउंस आर दोज प्रोनाउंस हु कांट एबल टू राइट विदाउट एनी अदर वर्ड्स सपोर्ट. And detached pronouns are those pronouns who are able to write without any other words support. Zamire munfasila. So ye kya hai? Zamire muttasila hai. Zalika kalamuhu, that is his pen. Baituha kabirun, her house is big. Here you can see baituha. This is also a zamire muttasil, means attached pronouns. Number 8. Hadikatuka jamilatun. Your garden is beautiful. Why they are using jamilatun here? Why they are not using jamilun? Because hadikatun is a feminine word. That's why they are using jamilatun, not jamilun. Understood, beta? Cause zamir muttasil means attached pronouns. Now, number 9, hakibatuka jamilatun, your bag is beautiful. See, hadikatun and hakibatun, some kind of similar word. You can see a spelling also, only they're different of dal and kaf, right? So, don't confuse in it, proper remember and keep it in your mind. Hadikatun means garden, hakibatun means a bag. Understood, beta? So, hadikatuka jamilatun, your garden is beautiful. Number 9, hakibatuka jamilatun, your bag is beautiful. Number 10, zalika tabibun, that is a doctor. Now, if you make a sentence for a feminine, that time we use tilka, and for a tabibun we use a tabibatun. Tilka tabibatun means that is a doctor, but that time that sentence and that statement for a feminine. Understood? So I hope you all are understood this 10 sentences. One more time I repeat the translation. Haza rajulun tabilun, this is a tall man. Zalika hajarun thakilun, that is a heavy stone. Number 3, hazihi zahratun jamilatun, this is a beautiful flower. Now see the other page, means page number 40. Tilka bakaratun saghiratun, that is a small cow. Haza darsun sahlun, this is a easy lesson. Number 6, zalika kalamuhu, that is his pen. Number 7, baituha kabirun, her house is big. Number 8, hadikatuka jamilatun, your garden is a beautiful. Number 9, hakibatuka jamilatun, your house, your bag is beautiful. Number 10, zalika tabibun, that is a doctor. So, two type of grammar point we learn in this lesson. First one is asmaul ishara, means demonstrative pronouns. And second one is zamir muttasil, means attached pronouns. I hope you all are understood both grammar point also. Asmaul ishara means demonstrative pronouns. There is a two type, isme ishara lil karib and isme ishara lil baid. And zamair means pronouns. It has also a two type, zamir muttasil means attached pronouns and zamir munfasil means detached pronouns. Understood, beta? So if you have any kind of doubt regarding this lesson or exercise or grammar point, you can ask me in our live classes. Inshallah, I'll teach you again. I explain you again that thing. But don't be confused and don't make a wrong sentence or wrong grammar point in your mind. That is a वो क्या हो जाएगा, फिर आगे जाकर आपके माइंड में एक चीज़ बैठ जाएगी, तो मतलब हर मर्तबा उस चीज़ के लिए आप गलती करोगे. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इफ़ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ स्मॉल डाउट देन यू कैन आस्क मी बेटा. ओके, सो नाउ यू स्टे होम, दुआ फॉर एवरीवन टू पीसफुल लाइफ. अस्सलामु अलैकुम.